Hi, I'm National Chief Perry Bellegarde of the Assembly of First Nations. It's a National Indigenous Peoples Month. And thinking back to my history of why I got involved in First Nations politics in the first place, I think back and I can honestly say it's all about bringing about change. Change and a better quality of life for our people as First Nations people. Change and better housing, quality education, better health care. To see our treaties that we have with the Crown honored and implemented according to spirit intent. And that's what drove me to get involved in the first place. And I think back, one of the elders that really had a big impact on me was late Elder Gordon Oates from the Nikanik First Nation. His First Nation's Indian name was Red Bear. And he was a strong teacher and mentor and role model. He focused on the importance of culture and language and ceremony as Plains Cree people. He focused on the balance between the white world and Indian world, First Nations world, and how we need two systems of education now to survive. And he would always talk about that analogy of a team of horses pulling. You know, one horse is like the education that we need in the white world, kindergarten to grade 12, and math and science, literacy and numeracy, on to university. But equally important on the other hand is the other horse. And he's talking about the Indian education, First Nations education, and the importance of our ceremonies and our language. You know, our Sundance lodges, our sweat lodges, our chicken dance ceremonies, our round dances, all of those things and how we're connected to the world. And then now, as we look forward, there's some huge opportunities available, not only in Canada, but globally. And one of the things that we're getting involved in is this great reset. In getting a better connection between humankind and our natural world, bringing together the public sector and the private sector to make sure that these billions and trillions of dollars in the future will be invested in finding the balance between the economy and the environment, investing in the clean, green energy sector, making sure that we have a sustainable economy and environment for the future generations, to think seven generations down the world. That's what it's all about. Thinking seven generations down the road into the future. And we have a huge opportunity. We need to collectively do this together because we're all connected and we're all related. Thank you so much for listening.